Joe Yumba, native of the Democratic Republic of Congo, applied for political asylum, citing fear of persecution from warring rebel factions, currently living in a hostel. Do you have any African friends in Ireland?
No.
Do you know a man called Erasmus? He's from the Congo too.
I don't know him.
You don't know him?
No, I don't.
Erasmus is a gangster, a pimp, a drug dealer. You've been here for over a year. You're both from the Congo. You don't look like someone who uses drugs. Soon it's going to be West Africans who control the drug trade in this city. Men like you. And men like Erasmus. Men who sat where you're sitting and told me the same thing. They know nothing and no one. Married with one child. Whereabouts of wife and child unknown at this time.
We think they're both in London.
Give him his card.
You're bound by law to carry this at all times.
That piece of plastic means you have leave to stay in this country, where you are bound by the laws of the state and the governing laws of the European Union, just like the rest of us. You also have leave to seek employment. Do you understand?
I do. Thank you.
Thank you.
The vault.
Bloody hell, lads.
I'll call him back in 1 minute. That's far enough.
How long you worked here, Joe?
1 month.
Any training? Army, police?
Just what the company taught me. 3-day training course.
How do you find a job?
I'm happy to have a job.
Good. That's all I need. Take care of yourself.
Since you started working here, Joe, we haven't been robbed once, so you can relax.
Hello, Joe. Do you mind if we speak alone?
Is something wrong?
You know these people?
We're bringing them over on a family reunification visa. They arrive in the country tonight.
It's been a long time, hasn't it? Well, I'll I'll leave you to it. Nice to meet you, Carla. You be a good boy and do what your mom and dad tell you, okay? Good luck.
Thank you. Sekileti kitu ambao inafanyika sisi tuko familia. Umesikia Daniel? Mimi mba yako. Sisi tuko familia. Ni sasa. It's a dream. It's a dream. It's a dream. It's a dream.
You wind it up and then jump around like a real frog.
You like it? Do you mind?
Sure, no problem. Beautiful.
Will you say my prayers with me?
What do you pray for?
I pray that the bad men won't find us. Are there bad men in this country?
Yes. They are.
Will they come for us?
No, I won't let them.
You promise?
I promise. I'll always be here for you. Both of us. We'll always be here for you. You carry those you love. Music you carry in your head. Remember that. And and no one can hurt you. Ever.
See you soon.
Understand?
Yes.
One, two, three.
Nothing but fucking fouls.
Sorry about me, brother. And we're mad at the best for us. Look how we torn hell. Can I ask you a personal question? Have you ever had a knitting needle inserted into the urethra of your phallus? Some men derive intense pleasure from inserting objects into the penis during arousal. They have to start small and then work their way up through progressively larger objects until, after some time and toughening of the inner flesh, they can insert a lubricant-covered knitting needle all the way in. Not the most flattering portrait. You look good in uniform. Here's the thing. Inside that building is something that we want. And you're gonna help us get it. Now, why should you help us? I've a family myself, a little girl. If anything were to happen to her, Jesus, we'd go mental. Is it the same with you? Is it the same attachment? I mean, life is cheap. Where you come from, right? This is how it's gonna be. Tomorrow, you go to work as normal, but tomorrow night, midnight, at the bank, kill the alarms, disable the cameras, open the back door, and get us into the vault. We don't care how you do it. Do you know what these are? Don't suppose you ever needed them. Interesting thing about these pills is when you fail to take enough of them, you've an erection whether you want one or not. Stripped naked and tied to a chair, you feel very vulnerable. And when the needle is heated, do as I say and you'll have your family back, but you go to the cops. What effect force fed to an 8-year-old do you suppose these pills will have? Like I said, you go to the cops. Midnight. Get it done.
was throwing up, is that what you said?
That's what it looked like.
Did you see him get into the barn?
No, we came across it just before he got out.
You're absolutely certain?
It was him. I'm positive.
What business do you have with Eddie Gilroy? We know you were with him, Joe. And this man? Ever seen this man's face? Let's be clear about the situation here. By fraternizing with known criminals, you have endangered your asylum status. We have good grounds to rescind that status and send you home. You and your family. Back to the Congo. How does that sound to you? Two men were murdered last week. We know this man was responsible. What were you doing with him? You need to tell us, Joe. Leave us alone, please. You stay silent, and we have to assume the worst. That you are an associate of a known scumbag and a possible accessory to murder.
I've done nothing wrong. I don't know nothing about this man's business or any murders. My family's waiting for me.
You're free to go.
Oh, I was watching when he bought you this. Cheap shit.
Yes, they are.
Will they come for us?
No, I won't let them.
You promise?
The needs heat. I promise. Why are you spying on me?
I'm not spying, I swear to God. I've been living here the last 2 weeks. I swear to God, there are no sensors here. They don't move around. No one knows. My wife kicked me out. I have nowhere else to go. Please. Please don't hurt me.
I don't understand. The police, I mean, surely, if you explain, your wife and son have been kidnapped.
Explain? Can't take that chance. This way, there is a chance.
When will they be here?
5 minutes.
No!
No! No! No! Let me out! Let me out of here! Listen to me!
Listen to me.
If you do this, you will have the blood of my family on your hands.
I'm sorry.
Don't do this. Don't do it. Back him!
You alone?
Yes.
Cameras?
They're all off. Where are they?
Discuss the plan. You'll have your wife and kid back first thing in the morning.
In the morning? No, no. Tonight.
You don't gotta say in this. My gang, my reels, understand? And lead the way. Lead the way! Stay here, fat boy.
Together. 3, 2, 1. Turn.
Which one, Eddie?
Number 20L.
Frankie wasn't lying. 2 million of your own barrel bonds.
Roy, get to work. Deal the rest of it.
2 million euro barrel bonds. It's all there. Come on. Go over here now. I'll get that one. Get it. Oh, yes. Look at this.
Wait a minute. Wait. Where's he going?
Plank!
Where the fuck are you?
We're rich!
Pack up, we're leaving.
What?
Neil.
Dead.
Shut up, you. Plank, pick up.
Dead.
Plank.
You hear me?
Plank, come back. Get up.
Your family's dead.
It's all right, Eddie.
Fucking dead.
It's all right. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come
on. Fucking nose.
Shut the fuck up, Antoine.
Drop the gun. And the bag. Just your bag. Throw it to me.
We still have your wife and kid.
When you bring them to me, I'll hand this over. I want them back. Nothing else. You keep the rest.
Hey!
Bring them to me.
I said, nobody's going anywhere. We'll bring them to you in the morning. You see how sharp he is at them. He's been up all night.
Not finished yet.
Holy Mother of God.
When they see this, it's over.
Well, we can't hide the damage, that's for sure. But we can't delay them fighting it. I haven't emptied bins the last 17 years without picking up a few pointers on how things work around here. You see that? That's the time lock.
Who else was in the vault last night?
No one.
Well, someone must have touched it. It's on. It can only be set from the inside.
Well, don't look at us.
Set the bloody alarms.
Joe, there's a phone call for you.
Hello?
Are you having a party there, Joe? Oh, someone here wants to talk to you.
Who?
Daniel! Are you okay?
Yes.
I'm coming for you. I'm coming to take you home.
We should meet.
I'm ready.
You know, I'm getting fond of these two. She's a beauty, isn't she? And the kid. City Center. Henry Street. 11:30. Alone.
me.
How are you?
I know, no, nothing. We haven't spoken in a while, so.
Units responding to an alarm call at the European Capital Bank. It's the same bank Joe works at, right?
I'm sorry, I have to go. What's going on?
False alarm. It's nothing.
The vault's down this way, sir.
Problem here.
We're locked out of the vault. Can't get in.
Locked out?
The time lock slipped.
These things don't slip. Someone's reset it.
What's in there?
The whole bank. Everything. Is there some kind of problem? I'm the manager.
Joe.
You wait 2 hours, and you hand this to Detective Harbison. You hear me? Only Harbison.
2 hours. Harbison. I hear you. Just bring your family back. Go. Go on.
Before we get this thing off.
Done.
Hey!
Hey! You've no business cutting through here.
What's where you're fucking going?
Excuse me.
We didn't hear you say sorry. Daggy.
Yes, we'll chat up. Just listen. Here's what you're gonna do. Look down the street, the blue van. You give me the bag, I'll bring our family across to you. It's that simple.
Where's Daniel? I don't see Daniel.
Look up and see who's at the window. Hand me the bag. You can walk in there and collect your kid. Couldn't be simpler.
Oi, nigga!
What the fuck?
I'm gonna fucking kill you, you black bastard!
Back off.
Get the fuck!
Listen, pal, you've no idea what you're walking into here. You're making a very big mistake.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oi! Oh!
Daniel!
Is everything all right, sir? Can I help you?
Hey, little boy. My little boy. Have you seen him?
No, I haven't. Sorry.
Daniel! Daniel! Daniel!
Hold it right there!
I understand what you've been through, Callow. But we need your help if we're to find your son. Joe isn't your husband, is he? Tell me the truth. If you tell me, I can help you.
If he lied, then I'm dead.
Save your compassion for the 9 o'clock news.
See you later.
If he lied, I'm betting there's a good reason he did.
I've no doubt there's a good reason he lied. Every one of them's got a good reason to lie, but we can't be taken in by any of it. You want to know this man's story? Stick around. We'll find him. And when we do, you'll see what kind of a man he is. If you don't speak, we'll be forced to review your asylum status. You know what that means, don't you? I can help you. Daniel, are you his mother?
His mother's dead.
Who is Joe Calla? Tell us who he really is. Are you afraid, Calla? Are you afraid of him? What did he do to you, Calla? What happened to you in Africa? See, she's okay.
I'm from the Lenda tribe.
Okay.
I come from a little village in the northeast of Congo. I live there with my husband, his parents, and our two children. War came to our land in springtime. It didn't touch us where we lived. We never thought it would. Rumors and terrible stories soon came to us. We were very afraid. Many people left the land, but we couldn't. We had nowhere to go. The Emma militia came to kill us in the first week of April. We took the children and hid in the fields. The men stayed to fight and The men said to fight and hold them back. But it was useless, there were too many. With axes, spears, and knives, they butchered every one of the men who stayed to protect us. And then they came and chased us down. They killed our children in the fields and dragged us down to the village. For 2 days and two nights, I was screaming, filled the air. Terrible. Terrible screamings. And then the screaming stopped. The land militia came, but it was too late. Everybody was already dead. Everybody except Daniel and I. They slit my throat and I fell into darkness. When I opened my eyes, I saw Joe. He saved me, and he saved Daniel too.
Did Joe live in your village?
Yes. He lived among us, but he was not one of us.
He told us he was a musician. Was he lying?
Tell us, Carla. Tell us what you know.
I can't.
Is Joe a bad man, Carla?
No, he's a good man. I love him.
Then you can help him. He's in real danger. Daniel, too. Will you at least tell us who he is?
I promise him I will never tell. There is another man. Also from the Congo.
Erasmus.
He knows the real Joe.
Wakati huna pahali pengine pa kuenda. Umependuka kwangu.
Nakuhitaji. Mtafute umo mulana.
Kwa nini nikusaidie?
Kwa sababu tumeona mengi pamoja.
Munyeshi heshima yoyote.
Siwezi. Sheria ya mwembe.
Kwa hivyo, umekuja kwangu. Huyo mwanamke akumpenda, sivyo? These men. Find where they are. Find your boy. Until then, I'll fix you somewhere to live. I'll bring the boy to you.
No. tell me where he is. That's all I need to know. I bring him home myself.
Yes?
Who is this?
Let me speak to Erasmus.
What about Joe? You know him?
For the gang behind the robbery at the European Capital Bank on Dublin's Merrion Road. Gardaí are particularly anxious to speak to the security guard at the branch, Mr. Joe Yumba. Anyone with information regarding his whereabouts is asked to contact the local Gardaí station. As prices are set to rise again following the leveling off of recent months,
clothes. If you're sorry you hear me, you don't know who you're fucking with. Whoever the fuck is there, you be sorry. Who's there? Who are you? Who's there?
Just let me go now and we forget the whole thing, alright? We don't know you. So just let me go now and we forget everything.
Where's the boy?
Oh, boy.
Ah!
crazy.
Fucking brother. It's mental. It'll fucking kill me, it will. If I tell you, he'll kill me.
I won't kill you. No. If you don't give me an address, I'm going to keep you alive so I can do worse things to you.
Please let me go.
These little pills, designed to bring such pleasure, but in your twisted hands, such an inventive use for them. I have my own methods, my own tools, but yours, very impressive. Bed for a white boy. What is it that makes a man? Is it the head? The heart? Something else?
Believe it! You bastard, you break my fucking nose with you!
Check the bag!
Where's my fucking brother? How'd you find us?
He's not here.
Where is Daniel?
Eddie! Inside!
Daniel!
It's all there.
That's a new fucking noisy, yes. Man. Woo!
Daniel.
Rough ride, is he?
He's okay.
Should have been here when his wife walked out. That was a barrel of laughs.
He separated?
A few months, yeah. You know the story?
No.
No one told you?
Tell me what?
Lost his kid. Son. 4 years old. Knocked down on the road outside his house. Killed.
Ah, God.
Tough, yeah. Only child. Guess it's hard to hold a marriage together after something like that.
Congo is not like any place you've ever been. I have seen things you people could not even imagine in your worst nightmares. Killing. Killing. Killing.
Did you take part in the killing?
Yes.
Get someone from justice down here.
Yeah, you bring them down. You bring them all down. You all learn something.
So, tell us.
Two tribes, Hema and Lendu. The Hema militia came and killed my people, cut them, burned them. I am Lendu. We killed two. We killed plenty. Had to.
And Joe? What about Joe?
I found him in his village. We arrived after the Emma, when the clay had turned to red mud and ran with blood flowing over our toes. Joe was barely alive, tied to a chair among all the dead people. They beat him, cut him, and made him watch. He watched as they hunted down and set about butchering them all. Old, young, women, children. All of them butchered, and worse. And they made Joe watch it all. We saved him. He breathes now. But he died that day. The man we lifted from that chair is a ghost.
I brought you some music.
I don't want to hear it.
For me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes and listen.
Are they going to kill us?
I'll protect you.
You want to know who Joe really is?
Tell us.
He's a priest.
A priest?
Father Joseph. He was a man of peace, a good man. A leader that tried to bring our tribes together. Tried to make us all put down our weapons. We freed Joe from that chair. The Hema was still there when we freed him. Drunk on blood and killing. We slaughtered every last one of them. Father Joseph, he could not believe in a God after what he had seen. When he stood from the chair, it was with a poisoned heart he now saw the world and every man in it. Joseph spared no one. It frightened many to see what this good man had become. But it only made me sad. I knew then for sure what I'd always only guessed. That regardless of the man, the demon lies in all of us. Waiting. Just beneath the skin. Waiting to avenge.
Thank you.
death comes to all who embrace it. But it would not come to him.
Thank you.
You promise you'll never leave me.
Go inside. Go.
Shit. He's long gone.
Daniel, you know where he is, don't you?
You found me. I guess you know everything now.
I know you were a priest.
Yesterday I was a priest. A priest in a village full of smiling, happy people. Now I'm here. Thousands of miles away. And an ocean of blood separating me from that time.
I don't know what happened. I don't understand it. I tried to stop it. I tried to bring peace, but I couldn't. Instead, I brought death. And in the end, I too became a killer. I tried to stop the killing. I tried, but I couldn't. They all died because of me. I tried to save them. I could only save two. That was all. Only two. From so many.
Don't do this. I don't know the horror you've lived through. But I know loss. I know guilt. We're the ones still living, right? Come on, Joe.
Joe.
Joe. Ambulance. Come in, ambulance!
Does it hurt?
No, it doesn't. Daniel, the music. I hear it too.
I'm sorry, son. We need to go.
Please clear the way, please. Moving out. Thank you.
Thank you, folks. Let's go. Clear, 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 clear.
Stand up.
Set up a line for rapid
Clear.